Hello, hello, hello. What's tea? What's tea? What's tea? Give me the tea, ladies. Let's get this party started up in here. I feel like I haven't seen you all in forever. Did you miss me? Miss me, miss me? Now you gotta kiss me? Oops. Hello, 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 everyone. I hope everyone is doing well. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome to some Tuesday tea. I hope that y'all are doing well. How you been? As my granny would say, what you know no good? What you know no good? Someone said, missed you. Girl, I was here like a week ago. I wasn't here on Sunday because I'm a mother. So I needed to celebrate my day, girl. I needed to celebrate the day. I am a mother. Yes? Someone said a week is too long. Girl, what do you want me to do? What do you want me to do? Okay, let me see what the girls are talking about, honey. Let me see what y'all are talking about. Hey, Simone. Hey, Danielle. Hey, Eclectic. Hey, Manny. Hey, Shells. Ayan. Hey, Nelly girl. Hey, Char. Hey, Art Classy. Christak. Miley. Books on Nails. Nelly said we missed you. Girl, I missed y'all too. Yeah, Kathleen said, miss you, fairy godbrother. Miss y'all too. Nelly said a week is too long. Y'all are acting out. Poison Ivy said, got the notification right away. Yes, honey, because TikTok is not shadow banning me right now, honey. That's why. Linda said, I've been hearing your podcast since last week. Thank you, girl. I appreciate the support. Yeah. Our class said, hey, mother. Hey. Hi, Kiko. Hey, Jade. Tazia said, I just need to know what toothpaste you use because, okay, the toothpaste is called Veneers. It's great. Yeah? All right, ladies, let me know in the chat. Where are y'all listening from? Roll call. Where are y'all at? Let me know. What city are you in? What country? IG acting a fool. So I gotta stop IG, honey. Honey, IG said never gonna get it, never gonna get it. Where y'all located? Philly, Clovis, Ecuador, Raleigh, DMV, Johannesburg, Dallas, Atlanta, LA, Houston, Philly, New York, Buffalo, Minnesota. Chicago, Long Island, Chicago, Jersey, Houston. All right, y'all. All right, y'all representing, honey. Y'all representing. I love it. Memphis, I see you. That's where some of my people are. I'm originally from LA myself. If you can't tell by the Valley Girl accent, honey. Okay. Okay, so ladies, let me know. Do we need to listen to some R&B? Do we need to listen to some neo-soul? Do we need to listen to some ladies of rap? What are we giving tonight? What's the energy, honey? Let me know what the energy is. Let me see what y'all are giving. Someone said jazz. No, girl. No Dizzy Gillespie up in here, honey. I'm not gonna scat, scat, scat for your nerve. Somebody said death metal. Girl. Okay. Y'all are acting out already. Okay, let me see. I'm going to ignore the girl who said jazz girl, even though I love you to death. Okay, I'm getting some, it's mostly R&B. The R&Bs have it. All right, ladies. Sorry, honey. Sorry about it. Someone said death metal. Oh, okay, that's my girl. I know her. I was about to say. Girl, what? What should we start with? I think we should start with this. Most people say Do we know this, ladies? Yes, Tia. Miss Tia, honey. Yes. Okay, y'all my people. Y'all my people. Touch, honey. Emery. Okay. If y'all don't know me, sorry, I haven't even introduced myself. I've been on here for 5 minutes just talking some bullshit. Okay. My name is Anwar White. They call me Coach Anwar. I am a dating coach for Black and Brown women, and I help them heal their hearts, date with strategy, and get into the best relationship of their lives. Yeah? So what I do on these lives is I will answer your questions, put your questions in the chat, and I will answer them in the order that I see them. So if you want to learn a little bit more about what I do, you can definitely go to the link in my bio that has a link to my podcast, a link for free trainings, a link to book a call with me if you're interested in working with me. Yeah. So we're going to go with that, and we're going to get it together, honey. We're going to keep it moving, honey. And by the way, we're all family here, so don't act brand new. If you got a question, put it in the chat and I'm going to answer it. Now, please know that we might get to at least 1,000 women up in here, and you might have to be patient, girl. Yeah? All right. With that said, let's see what the girls are talking about. T-Saucy said, why is your live not working on Instagram? I don't know, girl. IG is not it, honey. So I had to let it go. Romeo said, I need a dating coach bad. I know you do, girl. I see some of your TikTok videos, girl. You do. I'm glad that you're here. I think that you are so funny, and I think that you are one of the next best things, girl. Okay, Grass said, hey, I have a question. My man's female friend tries to make me jealous, but he doesn't what, girl? He doesn't see it. What should I do? You can't tell a guy what he should or should not think. The gag is, this is how you get guys to do things that you want. You just let him know, like, how it's making you feel. Hey, I really wanted to let you know that I really love the fact that you have such a great friend group. I will let you know that I am feeling a little bit uncomfortable with Sharon. And yeah, I just, for me, just let me know if she's around. I probably won't attend just because she's making me feel really uncomfortable right now. Right? So now he's got to figure out, why am I saying this? This is why I'm always talking about vulnerability, ladies. You got to share your feelings with him, because that's going to activate his masculine. Now he's got to figure out, how can I protect my girl? She's not feeling good. I got to make her feel good. And now he's going to do what needs to be done. Yeah, but if you're going to tell him, yeah, don't hang out with her anymore. Literally, what you're going to do is activate his testosterone, which is going to make him want to fight and defend. And he's going to go 10 toes down on staying friends with Sharon. Right? No, I feel uncomfortable. I don't feel really safe. Yeah. Hopefully that helps the girls. Okay. Okay. Let me see what y'all are talking about. Does anybody know about this song, Destiny's Child, Happy Face? Okay. Hala said, have you seen the billionaire comment that's trending right now? Yes, girl, but I knew that already. If you've seen some of my videos, you'll know that the billionaires, the wealthy men, the guys that are at the top of their game, they want to be with Black women. They want to be with Black women. And why? Because y'all keep it real. They are surrounded by yes men and women all day long, and y'all have a backbone to say, I don't see it. You're going to keep it real with them, and they appreciate it. It is refreshing for them. You're not going to bullshit them, right? And that is the thing that challenges them to even go on to greater heights, yeah? So I'm not surprised by that. I knew that. And that's why I'm one of the few dating coaches that is telling Black women, date everybody, honey. Date everybody. You'd be surprised who really lives for you and checks for you. I think y'all think, oh my God, like, I'm not one of those suburban girls, or, you know, I'm not one of those alternative girls that the white boys are checking for. Girl, they're checking for each and every one of you. And it's not just the white guys, it's just non-Black men. A lot of them are checking for you. I just need you to check back. Yeah? Okay. Kaz the Gemini said, any WLW coaching? Yeah, girl. Look, I coach all women, all races, although my coaching is centered around the Black and brown experience. I coach trans women, lesbian, bisexual women, everyone that identifies as a woman, honey. Come on in. Azalea said, suggestions for Chicago places to visit to find your man. I'll be in Chicago at the end of June, honey. I'm with my mother, of course, honey. Sporting events, that's where I would go. Chicago's a big sporting town. Poison Ivy said, would you coach clients who have bipolar disorder? That's why I have my consultation call, so I need to know exactly how that's being managed or not. Yeah. Kayla said, just got stood up by a guy. I'm too pretty for this. I know that's right. Ladies, if you're not having phone dates with guys before you're going out with them, then that's a huge missed opportunity. I'm pretty sure that you didn't have a phone date with this guy beforehand, because he would have stood you up in the phone date and then you would have cut him off. So ladies, have phone dates before you go out with any man. Bria, thank you so much for the GG, girl. Okay, OC girl, thank you so much for the rose. Lejay said, I need to know what you think about the soft guy era. I don't think anything about the soft guy era, because they're not on my radar, and they shouldn't be on yours either. These guys should not be in the consideration set. You know those guys when you were in kindergarten or first grade, and then you would say something, and then they would mimic you? You'd be like, hi, Miss Anne, can I go to the bathroom? And then they say, Miss Anne, can I go to the bathroom? That's what those guys are. Non-motherfucking factors. I don't know what this emoji is. Is it fucked up that I only want a man if he's able to provide for me? No, not at all. You should want a man like that. Don't let these guys make you feel guilty about wanting or needing that. Please understand that financial safety oftentimes can equate and is part of the emotional safety. Yeah? I had to tell one of my clients earlier, I said, girl, you get to want to dig for gold. What's wrong with that? We need to start owning this, right? Unless you want to, if you want to be in a house with no money, girl, like, love is not enough. And especially in this economy, girl, my grocery bill has gone up 30, 40%. And guess what? I'm not eating the grocery brand of yogurt. My shit's gotta be Yoplait or he gets no play. So you wanna be able to buy the things that you wanna buy and live the life that you wanna live. Or why even get coupled or partnered? You know what I mean? So anyway, and that's that. And that's on Activia. Don't, girl, own the shit. Own what you want and what you need, ladies. Yeah? Jen said, do Seattle, please. So many white men, but they're all 5'9". I don't know what's wrong with 5'9", honey. Guess what? Because a lot of the guys that are 5'8 and 5'9 have 8s and 9s. A lot of these 6'1s have 6s or less, honey. Don't let the hype fool you. Yeah? Molly said, I'm Canadian. My family's from India. Mid, plus size, quirky. Who's checking for me? Anime, gamers, A. That's who's checking for you. I would get with the white gamers girl. No shade. Jay said, my mom, black working professional, is recently divorced in Tucson. Where should she move next? I mean, let me think. The South is good. I mean, dating is difficult for everyone right now. So to be honest with you, it doesn't really matter where she moves. I think the most important thing that she has to focus on is what places she's going to be the happiest. Because when you're happy, you're going to radiate an energy and you're going to be magnetic. And you'll get a lot of different guys when you're living in that energy. Yeah. It's Queen Chelly said, I love your lives all the time. I need to book a consultation with you. Then do it, girl. What you waiting on? Nash, thank you so much for the two roses. Haley said, how do I bring up that I want to move in together in his house? We've been together for 3 years. I think IDW means I don't want marriage or I do want marriage. I think that you need to have a conversation. First, I need to know what marriage, do you want it or you not want it? One of the things that I think is important is that you move in with a guy, but there needs to be an engagement with that move in. So, you know, first of all, you need to talk about marriage with this guy. If it's past 2 years, the probability of you getting married goes from 53% down to 17%. So you need to talk about if you want to get married, and I'm assuming that you do. Let's just make that assumption. Maybe that's not your truth. You need to let him know what would make me feel really good about moving forward in this relationship is being engaged in the next 3 to 6 months. We're not saying he has to do it. We're just sharing exactly what would make you feel good. Yeah. Falling Miami said Bumble and their billboards. Bumble fumbled. Yeah. The gag is that they're wrong. They're saying celibacy is not the answer, but it actually is. When you are not giving it up, you're going to find your guy faster. That's the gag of it. Lin Lin said, OMG, I can't believe I got on your live. I love your videos. Do you have a podcast? I do. It's called the Get Your Guy Coaching Podcast. Definitely check it out. Y'all subscribe to it. Follow it. I publish an episode every couple of weeks. I think you'll love it. And thank you all so much for the 19,000 likes. If you like anything that I say, if anything resonates with you, definitely tap. Double tap, triple tap the screen. Sam said, how soon is too soon to start dating after a serious breakup? Well, it depends on the nature of the relationship and the breakup, right? Like, if you were in a two-year relationship, that's going to be a different rebound process than, like, a two-month. And if the relationship was narcissistic, then it might take you that amount of time to get back on your feet. So it really just... The nature of the relationship matters. I can't give like a broad stroke on that. Triple Star said, guys, don't talk to me. My question for you is, girl, do you talk to them? Because most of y'all are out here cute and mute. And you, it's like somebody put baby in a corner. Y'all need to talk to these men, honey. Yeah? And don't give me this I'm shy shit. Have a conversation. You wouldn't be shy if you were at a house party and you were hosting. You wouldn't be shy if you were at Sephora and you needed a lipstick in a certain shade and they didn't have it on display. You talk to somebody right away. If you were in Kohl's and they had only X large and you needed a medium or a large, girl, we don't act shy about that, and I don't want you to act shy around these men. Yeah? Okay, let me see what y'all are talking about. Mammy, mommy, he is very financially stable and he is flying me out to visit. He's booked me my own apartment. Okay, girl, be careful. If this is the first time that you're meeting a guy, I always recommend for him to come to you instead of you come to him, because you want to be on your home base. The NBA playoffs are happening right now and you have an advantage. You have a power advantage when you are familiar with your surroundings. When you are not and things go awry, you're going to feel asked out. You're going to feel unhoused and you're going to feel disempowered. And I never want you to be in that position. So something to consider. Amber says, how do you get your man to show all love languages, not just acts of service? Well, no shade, but research has said that love languages are BS. So I think you need to get clear about what are your deeper relationship needs and how he can fulfill them, right? And why you have those needs. So that's the work that we can do on our end. We can't make a man do anything. And if you're trying to do that, then you are trying to be in control of something that you will never be in control of. It's like trying to control the weather. You can do the rain dance if you want, girl. Nothing coming out of that sky. And it's the same with a man. He's got what he's got. And your job is to see if it works for you or if it doesn't. And if it doesn't, we got to step away. Anne Lee said, I just broke up with my boyfriend who had a horrible communication, but I am hurting. Should I reach out? No. One of the things that I have in my program is what I call my breakup plan. And the first step of that is you have to go no contact for at least 3 to 4 weeks. Have to. If you're not ready for that, then you're really not ready to break up. Please understand that if this guy was your future husband, you would never break up with him. I truly believe that. Jaleesa said, just started interracially dating. What areas in LA should I go to meet white men? I would go to Beverly Hills. I would go to Santa Monica and Venice Beach. And then I would go a little bit south and go to like the Orange County area and things like that. Yeah. But girl, also go to Glendale. Get yourself a Persian king. Literally. Yeah? I am Norse said, he's my favorite person on TikTok right now. Thank you, girl. Ellen said, finally dated a white guy and he was the nice guy. Everything was going great. Then he told me he's... Y'all literally got me on the edge of my seat with some of these unfinished questions. Now I'm gagged and I don't even know what he was doing. Okay, I gotta move on, honey. Ken Bino said, how to flirt at the luxury gym for shy girls. I go to Equinox and I have bad resting bitch face. Well, one of the things to help with resting bitch face is like, imagine smiling in your head and you will naturally give like, if you're currently like this, it'll at least get you neutral, girl. Now, I'm not trying to promise that you'll go full-on Joker, because I think that's a huge shift, an overcourse correct, but you at least want to go neutral. The other thing that you can do is start talking with teeth, like this, or resting your top teeth on your bottom lip. That's what I tell my kids to do on school day, girl. And the pictures always serve. Always. Yeah? But beyond anything and everything, like, that shit doesn't actually matter. I was bullshitting about the smiling. This is about starting conversations. Here's the thing. You're not shy around family. You have given yourself this label of shy, but there are certain people in the world that you're not shy with. What I want you to think about is, I want you to pretend like these men that are out here, that they work for you. That they're your assistant or they work in the location that you're at, and ask them for help. Hi, can you do me a favor? Can you help me put this weight on here? Boom. Let me see. Ella said, this is why I love you and your content. Thank you, girl. Gotta have some more tips for skincare. Yours is flawless. It's not flawless. Everyone on TikTok, this is all like a little bit of a filter. Like, it's getting better, but don't let these filters gag you, girl. But I am gagged on snail mucin right now, rose water in the morning, and some tretinoin in the evening time for some of my darker spots. I do it full face, but especially I have like a little bit of a darker spot here. It's going away. The thing that I've been doing to make sure that those darker spots go away early, put the tretinoin on, but then I'm also putting a little bit of castor oil in, girl. Shit is disappearing, girl. Like some of these men that are ghosting you, no shade. Let them disappear, girl. Just like these dark spots. No shade, girl. This bat said, what are your thoughts on Kevin Samuels views? Girl, I don't listen to Kevin Samuels, girl. You shouldn't either. Girl, Kevin Samuels is dead. And I don't listen to dead people. And I don't care about them. Except for maybe MLK. Let me see what y'all are talking about. Jordella said, am I wrong for not wanting to date a man with kids? I hear this a lot when it comes to Black women. And I think it comes from not wanting to be that girl. Not wanting to be, it's multifaceted. I think it's not wanting to be another baby mama, not wanting to be a stereotype. But also there is a deeper issue going on, which is oftentimes when we're growing up, we often don't get as much attention and we can feel very neglected. And when you go into a situation knowing that he has kids, you are going in thinking, oh my God, like I'm the best that I can do is silver place, right? Silver medal, because he's going to be always focused on his kids. And so I think a lot of people have pause around that. I think you want to figure out if he is an amazing father before you figure out if you want to know, like, whether you make the decision about going out with him or not. What if he's an amazing father who got into a relationship when he was young and it didn't work out because he's evolved and grown and now he's ready for the real thing? Yeah? Mammy said, so I gently mentioned it to him. Now he's not picking my call. I don't know what you're talking about. Nolan said, what to do when you're left on red? Girl, if you're hyper-focusing on one guy, like, I want us to get to the point where you're dating so much that you don't even know who's left you on red or not. The fact that you do lets me know that we're not dating enough. That means I want you to get on the apps. I want you to be talking with a variety of different guys so that you're talking to a good 3 to 5 guys where you're just trying to keep up. Yeah? As I scroll up, let me just say, if there's anything that I'm saying that's resonating with you, awesome. Like, double like, triple like. That means tap the screen. If you're interested in working with me, definitely book a consultation call. Every week I have at least 1, 2, maybe even 3 women that are getting in a great relationship. The woman that got into a relationship this week, travel nurse that is in the DMV area, and she got her guy. Last week, oh my God, I'm like losing I'm trying to figure out who was it last week. Who are the people that were getting their guy last week? Because there's so many people getting their guy. Oh, I also had another woman in the DMV area get her guy as well. Let me see this. I have a private Facebook group with over 200 black and brown women in there, and we get to do this work together. Okay, this woman is in Texas last week, and the woman after that was in Seattle. The woman after that was in New York. Yeah, I'm actually going to be in DC this weekend to meet up with all of my clients. We're hanging out on Saturday, so I'm looking forward to that. Precious said, I went on 2 dates and he wants me to get a passport to go on trips. Is this a red flag? Well, I don't really talk in red flags or green flags or any flags, but there are people that I've known for 5 or 10 years that I don't want to go on an international trip with because I know them. He doesn't know you. Even if y'all have been chatting for, let's say, 3 weeks, he doesn't even know 90% of you. So I have to question 2 things. One, you have to check in with yourself and figure out how it makes you feel and honor that feeling. But 2, I have to question his decision-making skills. He's making a decision and he doesn't even have all of the information or data. That's not someone whose decision-making or process feels good to me. That doesn't make me feel safe. Audrey said, what about dating D-list celebrities? The gag is dating a D-list celebrity is oftentimes worse than dating an A-list celebrity. And the reason is, and I already talked a lot of shit about these celebrities because they're ambitious, they're gonna want more for you, they're gonna cheat, they're going to put themselves and their career first and you not even in the consideration set. And they're into some kinky shit. Now, put all of that, because the same still applies for dating a D-list celebrity, but he just doesn't have the money. And no shade, because he's a D-list celebrity girl, he's probably gonna have to do some kinky shit to get to at least a B-minus celebrity. Let me see. What else is going on? Angel said, I just found out he's with 5 more girls other than me. Well, if y'all are casually dating, girl, good. Let him date. But guess what? Let that inspire you to get 5 more guys. Many of us are waiting to be chosen, and you need to be the chooser. This is what one of the things that I help my clients with. It's a mindset. It's also a strategy, right? So these men like to compete. So you need to let them compete. Based on your question, I already know that you're hyper-focused on this one guy. You're not dating. You're relationshiping. And there's a difference. And we need to date. And I call it Olympic dating. You need to have a gold medalist, a silver medalist, and a bronze medalist. If you don't have that, you got some work to do. We got some dating work to do. Let me see what's going on here. XJ said, hey, love, how much do your consulting calls go for? I'm really curious. You give amazing input. So the consultation calls are really for women that are considering working with me professionally. So you'll have to do an application. And if your application is accepted, then you can book some time with me. Yeah. So they're actually free $99. Sophia said, Anwar, I'm an extroverted, artistic, assertive, mid-sized Latino woman. Which men would want me? The Latino men want you, girl. The black men want you, girl. And probably about 50% of the white guys, girl. I think your tea is when I hear mid-size and extroverted, sometimes there are some women that will not lean into like their femininity and try to be the funny friend instead of like really leaning into their true feminine energy from the inside, right? Sharing feelings, letting men do things for them. Yeah. So I don't know you specifically, but that's often what I have noticed. And, you know, because of our lived experience, probably not setting as many boundaries as we need. And because of that, not getting the treatment that we want to have. Eva Morgan, thank you so much for the 5 hand hearts. I so appreciate it. Oh, girl. Whitney always gets me. Hall said, I'm a science nerd, college student. My boyfriend is mixed, mostly white, and an astrophysicist. Is this common? Girl, what is this question? Girl, I don't know. I don't know, girl. But my question is his mama white? Because that will tell me everything that I need to know. I don't care about the stars and the astros and the physics. I need to know about that mama. Because if the mama's white, then we gotta listen to Whitney. Thoughts on Nashville. Suburbs are cute. Nice gowns. But it feels like a white sorority downtown, and that makes me feel uncomfortable. A lot of my clients that have been in the Nashville area have gotten their guys, but it's been in the suburbs. Yeah. Okay. Someone says, so what if his mom is white? What that means is because the mother relationship is a very intimate and intense one, oftentimes many men, especially in this generation, will actually take on a lot of the attributes of the mother more so than the father. And there comes the lived experience is a bit more entitled and will have some hints of Karen. And what that looks like is potentially some narcissism, some entitlement, some enmeshment that is very hard to be coupled with. Yeah. My experience. But also, for all of the ladies here who have gone with the light skin and the biracial guys, share your experience here. I did a video about this, and girl, they thought I was an Uncle Tom. They called me a colorist. They called me X, Y, and Z. But that's the experience of most, black women. So, honey, they wanted to crucify me, girl. They really did. Yes, honey, the Drake effect. Without the BBL. Okay, let me see what y'all talking about. Rachel said, do you believe that men change for the right woman? You teach them how to treat you? Yeah, but it comes from them. That's why it always gags me when people are like, how can I make a guy do this or that? You can't. You just gotta be you. Be your best self. And if it's a connection, if he feels inspired to do that, he will. If he doesn't, you gotta keep it moving. Manny said, do you see success with women who are not on dating apps? Most definitely. I will say 2 to 3 years ago, I would say 80% of my clients were getting their guy from the apps. Now it's maybe 2/3, closer to 50%. Deline said, do we tell men we are dating that we are dating multiple people? If he asks, be honest. Why? Because you need to let him know that you're just not sitting next to the phone on a Friday night waiting for Brad to call. You're hot shit. You're not a fucking commodity. You got a lot of people chasing after you, and he's going to have to really come correct if he wants you. A lot of men will be turned off by that. Let them. Because they were not there to fight for you. They were not there to win. And we want winners. We don't want losers. We don't want men that just want to do the bare minimum and just get over. The men that your guy will be inspired by that, know that you are it, and understand why you have a lot of people chasing you, and will want to win you. Yeah? That's the tea. Tatiana said, dating bisexual black men, not DL, but out. I guess the question is, would I do it? Have I done it? Yes, when I was young and dumb and full of what? Would I do it as an older individual? Me personally, it's not my thing, but everyone's going to have their own, you know, sitch with it. Someone said, OMG, help, men are afraid of me now that I'm TikTok popular. Let them be. The same, if you're a doctor, if you're a lawyer, you're going to have a lot of men that are intimidated by you because you have higher status than they do. And they can never be in a relationship with you because they would feel emasculated because they wouldn't be able to provide for you. Let your status be help you in evaluating these men. So if you're on an app, some of these girls are like, do I put lawyer in my career? Yeah, girl, put lawyer. Girl, put PhD. Let them know everything you got going on. Don't lead with it because that doesn't necessarily make you who you are. But let them know what you're working with. Yeah? Gigi said, do you offer classes? I have two programs. I have a group program called the Get Your Guy Club, and then I have a VIP program that is more one-on-one. Yeah? So definitely, you know, they're depending on your budget and the level of accountability that you want and need, we can definitely get you together, honey. No shade. Andy P said, he is constantly playing pranks on me. Is he just childish or does he secretly hate me? Well, if you've already shared with him that you don't like that and it doesn't make you feel good and he continues to do it, then he is childish and he secretly hates you. Not either or, but and. I don't think you do. Let me see what the gag is. What are the ladies talking about tonight? NDF, baby, you caught that nice gown tee, honey. I love you for that. Oh, yeah, Brycey, you too. Serial entrepreneur. Great gowns, beautiful gowns. Yes, ma'am. This is why I fuck with y'all, because y'all get it, honey. Some of these other people, if you don't know, you don't know. I love it. The Haitian beauty said, can we talk about Portland, Oregon, especially for women of color? I have a client that's in Portland. She got her guy. It's possible. But here's the gag, girl. You can't get with just any lumberjack. The gag with Portland is that, and I did a video about this, you gotta check the hair. If he's over 35, no hair, bald tee, get into that. But most of the Portland guys that you'll get into are either gonna be older and bald, like, or like have longer hair. That's the tea. Yeah. Erica said, when is it a right time to tell the guy that you're a single mom? Well, if you're meeting a guy on an app, you should put it in your profile. If you are met him offline, tell him on the first date. Annabelle said, how do you start the exclusivity talk? It's so interesting. So tonight in my group call that I have on Tuesdays and Thursdays, I actually went through my own framework of how to have the exclusivity commitment conversation. And then afterward, we did some role playing, which was a lot of fun. Yeah. So in my program, we teach it all, honey. Who knows about this song? Okay, I'm lost. I'm lost in the sauce, honey. So many comments. Thank you all so much for the 57,000 likes. I love it. Gotta have some more. Okay, Anwar, who creates the playlist? Moi, girl. Moi. Olivia said, what if you make 200K and he makes 100K? Where are you located? Because if you're in San Francisco or New York, girl, that's not, that might not do a lot. No shade. Yeah. The other question I have for you is, how is he navigating the courtship process? Is he taking care of everything? If so, continue to date him. But you'll have to have serious conversations about his ability to continue that throughout the courtship. So you might want to take a little bit of time before you grow exclusive with him, just to see if he can handle courting you and providing for you. Winter Harris said, loved your top dating sites video, found my soulmate in Maryland. I'm not surprised. Maryland, Northern Virginia, Raleigh, Research Triangle area, great places for Black women to date. Some questions around the pricing of my program. So the Get Your Guide Club, depending, I have payment plans, but the full payment is around $2,500. The VIP is around $6,000. User 209 says, how to stop coming off as cute. Cute means you're a little girl. You're giving little sister energy, right? So what does that mean? It means that your energy might be a little bit like, it doesn't give woman. There's a difference between princess energy and queen energy. Princess energy is like spoiled brat energy, right? Queen energy is like, I don't want to say bossy, but boss, meaning I have, and I boss not by telling a man what to do, but sharing with him my boundaries, what you're willing to do and what you're not willing to do. With a smile. Don't need to raise your voice. You don't need to nag. You don't need to complain. You just get to share what you want. And if it doesn't happen, you step away. Yeah. So if people are calling you cute, now, obviously, sometimes that has to do with stature and physicality, but oftentimes it's an energy. There are a lot of petite girls out here that men are not calling cute. Someone said, I'm still obsessed with a man that rejected me. Why? A couple of reasons, potentially. One, so in my program, we do this exercise called Deadly Dating Patterns. And one of them is what we call I'll Make You Love Me, which is a dating pattern that oftentimes we get from our parents. So no shade, if you had a dad that was emotionally absent, physically absent, if your mother was highly critical, then you might have a rejection kink. No shade. that's actually part of your bonding pattern, that these people have to reject you a little bit for you to feel like you want to lean in. Lexa, you're doing the Lord's work. Thank you, girl. Honey, when this song came on in the club in college for me, I was the biggest hoe in the world. Girl, anybody could have taken me home. I thought I was Maya girl. I thought I was the girl. I thought I was it, girl. I was putting it on everybody in the dance floor. Now, was I alone? Please don't leave me out hanging, girl. Something about this song that lets me have it, honey. Honey, I was whining on these mofos, girl, in the after hours club, which means that those guys are really gangsters. They will shoot you. And girl, you know what? I wanted to be shot. If you know what I mean. Girl, what is it about this song, girl? And I'm not even a girl. And I wanted to be his girl. Girl. Yes, girl. I don't know what it is. It makes me want to be a hoe. And I'm a Christian girl. I don't even cross fast enough, girl. Like, what? Something about this song, girl. Anyway. Someone said Beanie Man, though. Well, I'm not really into that look. That very couture look. But the sound makes me move my body. Someone says they having flashbacks. I know that's right. Somebody said we all had that one song. Well, ladies, let me know what that one song is that makes you let anybody have it. Yes, it is Maya's voice, honey. Curious Cat said, I'm with you, Anwar, in the club kissing. Kissing men that you don't even know their name. What is this? Somebody said, Keith Sweat Nobody. Somebody said, Move Your Body, Nina Sky. Someone said, Baby Boy, Beyonce. Someone said, Me and You, Always. Someone said, Usher, Yeah. Someone said, Shabba Ranks, Mr. Lover Man. Now, you know you wrong for that, girl. Someone said, Breakdown. Breakdown? Well, then you really got to break it down, girl. Someone said, I'm Still in Love, Sean Paul. Okay, naughty girl. Okay, let me see what else. Oops by Tweet. Okay, I see that. I see that. Yes, honey. Kayla said this song will control your hips. You just can't help it. Can't. It's spiritual. Honey, sometimes it's like that. Okay. Let me see what the girls are talking about. Someone said Maxwell. I know that's right. Milkshake. Okay, honey. Yes. Good. Maya, My Love is Like, Whoa. Mm-hmm. Rude by Rihanna. Look Back at It, Trina. Well, I don't know about that mess, girl. I'm gonna have to listen to that. Freakum Dress. Okay. Nice and Slow by Usher. Work by Riri. Okay, good. Red Light Special. I love it. I love it. I love it. Okay. It lets me know that I'm not alone here and y'all are just as messy as I am. Now, Mara saying My Neck, My Back, I think takes the cake. I think that's the song that most people will let them have it. Yes? One time I was at a bar in Chicago. So all the Chi-Town girls, y'all know how you act. my neck, my back came on, and everybody started getting it in the bar. Like, it almost became like an orgy of sorts. Like, the place started getting hot, the windows were steaming, everybody was like, rolling, girl. I was like, where am I? What just happened? So I believe it, girl, my neck, my back. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Oh my God, thank you so much for this hat. I feel like Cowboy Carter up in here. Yes, said Anwar, thoughts on Chicago men? Well, I always tell my clients in Chicago, you're gonna have to date everybody. You can't act like Chicago and be segregated when you're dating. Yeah, you actually have to date everybody, which means sometimes you might have to go to the northern part of the city, honey, not the south side. What do I think? I think similar to New York and similar to DC, there many of the guys, at least in the consideration set, are very like career focused and oftentimes aren't necessarily as ready to settle down. But yeah, I think it's a great city. Don't sleep on the suburbs. The girls are always focused on like the downtown, what's going on in the city. Girl, it's really the suburbs. Yeah. Okay. What other questions do you have for me, ladies? I'm sorry. That Maya song. And yes, I said Maya song, girl. It really got me together. And a mess at the same time. Yeah. Okay. What other questions do we have? Tips on dating Cali men. Don't. The big cities are very difficult to date in. Like I said before, you got to put your radius wide. If you're in LA, everybody is trying to be somebody. And if they're trying to be somebody, they're not focused on you. They're focused on getting over. This is really difficult. So if I'm in Cali, what I'm doing is, again, I'm dating everybody. And my radius is wide on my dating apps. And let's say I'm in LA, yeah? I'm also going out, but I'm going out like to just one place, but I'm doing it regularly, yeah? A lot of people, one time they'll be downtown, the other time they'll be in Beverly Hills, the other time they'll be in Santa Monica. In LA, like places like that, you think you'd be like diverse. You don't want people that are going to be everywhere. Because the people that are like more stable and not trying to be seen in the hottest places are the people that are going to be more ready for a relationship and not trying to do too much. I know it sounds counterintuitive, but that actually is a great kind of strategy in the area. Okay, let me see what y'all are talking about, honey. And he said, just started the podcast. I love it. Good. It's called the Get Your Guy Coaching Podcast. Definitely check it out. Subscribe, follow. It's anywhere that you listen to podcasts. The last episode was with a client named Stephanie who got her guy in ATL, mind you, because I know the ATL girls know that it's a challenge and almost impossible. It's not. It just takes a little bit longer. And she met her guy offline because she decided to have a conversation with the guy. And I want to encourage all of you to do the same. Your girl said, hi, Anwar. What's your take when dating, but you have a dysfunctional family you don't want him to meet? Only let him meet the sanest person in your family. I'm more of a very intimate setting. That's it. And if the family is dysfunctional, you probably don't want to be engaging with it a lot either. Bad gal. Advice for dating while Christian. So one of the biggest things that I think is really important for Christian women to consider and to think about as they are navigating their dating journey is you're going to have to put in work. You're going to have to create your love life. You can't wait for love. You're going to have to create it. And the Christian girls, the gag about the Christian girls is that they think that they, if they try to create their love life, they think that they're going against God because God's just going to give it to them. And if they do it, if they lean into it, they make it mean like they don't believe in God and his power and his omnipotent, you know, being. No, girl, faith without works. So you're going to have to work and you're going to have to create your love life. So lean into it. Go to the places that you need to go to. Be on the apps. Talk with individuals. That's the biggest advice that I would tell any Christian woman to do. Because a lot of the girls, they're going to Bible study on Wednesdays. They're going to church on Sundays and then teaching the Sunday school. And then just waiting for it to appear and happen. And in 2024 and beyond, that's the probability is going to become less and less that that is going to happen. Yeah. So, and I say that with love and respect as someone who also grew up in the church. Someone said church single group. Mm-mm, not that. Don't do that. So please, I want you to kind of reframe the thinking about that, which is, respectfully speaking, do the damn thing. And know that that's what God wants you to do. Views on men that just got out of a relationship a month ago. It's too soon. Probably want to wait for another 2 to 3 months. Tata Doe said, Amor, what does it mean when they say you have a mean walk? Well, I don't know. I need to hear the tone because they can either basically be saying you're Naomi Campbell or that you are Viola Davis in How to Get Away with Murder. So I don't know, girl. Let me see what else y'all are talking about. NDF said, thank you for the podcast. You're so welcome. The Leah J, I love your whole life, Amor. Thank you, girl. Your girl said, thanks so much. You're welcome. And Mina, thank you so much for the 15 finger hearts. And thank you all so much for the 78,000 likes. I so appreciate it. If there's anything that I'm saying that's resonating, please tap, double tap, triple tap the screen. All of that. Ashley said, you have helped me so much. Awesome. That's the thing. It's really interesting. I think I'm so glad that you all are getting some value from this, but please understand that this is just like a small sliver of the work that I do in my program. So if you're enjoying this, I need you to imagine exactly how transformative some of my programs can be. Please understand, I am your favorite dating coach's dating coach. That is what some of these dating coaches out here tell me. And some of these therapists, they share my stuff all the time. So in my programs, I go much deeper, which I think is really important to really make the connections and internalize how to change the patterns that we currently have. Yeah. I thank you so much for that compliment, Ashley. I really do appreciate it. And it is really an honor to do this work, especially as a Black man for Black and brown women, because being able to work with a black man can be healing in and of itself. And someone like reminded me of that yesterday. And especially if you have had issues with black men, if you have, you know, had strange relationships with your father, this can be really helpful. Shante says, so you're just gonna read me, huh? I mean, I've been doing this work for 14 years, so I know what the Christian girls go through. I know how they justify things, all of that. Sophia said, I thought you said the apps are not apping. They're not apping, but I will say this month they've picked up a little bit. But I said the apps are not apping so that we can diversify our dating, both online and offline. A lot of the girls are working from home, living from home, and trying to date from home. And what I want to offer to you all is that you got to get out. Okay, so I think I'm gonna go. Gotta get this beauty sleep, girl. I got a tennis lesson in the morning. Miss Carter said, I need a session with you. If you wanna work with me, definitely book a consultation call and we can see if it's a good fit for both of us. Yeah, I wanna let you know I don't accept everyone into the program, but if I feel like I can help you, if I feel like you're coachable, I will definitely invite you into the program. Silhouette said, thank you, Fairy Godbrother. You're so welcome. Imani said, you should write a book. I'm writing a book every morning. It's the first thing that I do because I get that statement 10 times a day. So it continues to inspire me and encourage me. Yeah? All right, ladies. I hope that this session was really helpful for you. Thank you all so much for the roses and all of the logos or icons. Picasso said, and why I need advice on saying I love you for both partners in a relationship. Okay, I'm gonna have to answer that at another time, girl. That sounds deep, heavy, yeah? All right, ladies, be well, and I will talk with you all soon enough. Someone said, let's get to 1,000 first. No, girl, it's okay, girl. I appreciate all of the likes. We don't need to get to 1,000 or 100,000. Y'all, let's go to bed, honey. This week is a week. Yeah. Be well. Book a call if you want to work with me, and I will talk with you soon. Alrighty? Bye now.